Hi everyone, in this video, we're going to be going over advanced Excel functions, and in particular, dynamic arrays. So recent versions of Excel, including Office 365 and Microsoft 365, have introduced some new functions that now allow you to work with dynamic arrays. These are basically tabular kind of data, as you see here, and it allows you to manipulate with a single formula a lot of information and create some dynamic results. So we're going to use this particular tutorial to discuss three of these formulae, and we're already seeing the results of some of them on the right hand side, but I'm going to quickly show you what the results look like, and then we're going to deconstruct the formula that makes them work. So as you can see here on the left hand side, there's a table of information that includes one line for each invoice with the customer name, the city, the state, the country, etc. What we have on the right hand side are what looks like manual extracts from there that first of all give us sales in descending dollar value for any specified state. In this case here, it's Massachusetts, and they also show us each city into which we've sold anything to. So I guess, you know, one line per city, and if you like, a unique list of cities that are included in this data. But, you know, here's the thing. These are dynamic arrays, so I'll show you that in two ways. Firstly, I can change the state that I'm looking at. So let's just say I want to look at, I don't know, Alberta. Type in AB. It updates that first list immediately. And, you know, say we want to look at Ontario, we'll get an updated list of Ontario. And if we go back to looking at, say, Massachusetts, which seems to have a few more, you know, now we're seeing the sales. So you'll notice in each case the sales were sorted in descending order of dollar value. The second thing is that both these will update in real time as we add or change data. So for example, if I decide that I'm going to relocate, Concord out of Massachusetts and into New York, I just moved to town. You'll notice that the descending sales for state has changed in real time. So I'll just undo that and put it back because that's where it really belongs. And also if I add a new entry here, so let's just say I manually add, Mark's company, for example, and just say it's Mark's company in Tinseltown, New York. I can make this maybe Massachusetts as well. And as I'm typing, those varies on the right hand side are updating. And if I put this at like 3000, for example, it just sort of the top of the list, and there it did. So I'm updating these arrays in real time, which is super useful. And you might wonder how I did this, but I took advantage of, you know, three formulae. So we'll get to that in a minute. So there's three formulae that we're talking about. The first one is the filter formula. The second is the unique formula. And the third is the sort formula. So the sort formula is actually one that I'm using around both the filter and unique formula to get the sort order that I want. The sort can be used on its own to sort a copy of your source data in any sort format or any sort order that you like. Okay. So I've gotten rid of the formula that I had for our descending sales by state, and now I'm going to reinstate that formula so I can show you how I do it. So we'll start in this particular column over here, and or I guess in this other column, and what we'll do is we'll start typing in a formula, and the formula is as you would expect, filter. The first argument that I place into the formula is an array. So an array is a number of cells in a grid. The array could be a single column and multiple rows, it could be a single row and multiple columns, but it's usually going to be a combination of multiple rows and multiple columns. So I'm just going to grab these columns. I really don't necessarily want the invoice number. So I'm going to grab those, and you'll notice that it started filling in my formula for me. I've defined the array, now I want to specify what to include. So I want to include all these records where the column was state. So I've grabbed that column equals, and now I can put in like an actual value if I wanted, type in open quote box MA close quote marks, but that's not going to be very flexible. But if I point to a specific cell and now close my brackets to finish the formula, that's how I actually get this array, this dynamic array. So again, if I choose this to Ontario, it's going to update. And if I change it, you're going to go to Massachusetts and update again. Now, the thing to notice is that this formula is only in the cell. In this case, it's cell I3. It's not in any of the other cells. If I click on one of the other cells, the formula still appears up here in the formula bar, but it is grayed out. It's not editable there. So this is the cell that contains the formula and these other cells both down and across, or, you know, what's called a spill area, where the data actually spills across into. So we'll just pause for a moment, because now what we're probably gonna want to do is change the sort order, because right now these are just sorted in whatever order they came out of the invoice listing from. So the invoice order number is probably not all that useful when you're trying to do any kind of business analysis and use it as a decision support tool. For example, say you're trying to figure out who your most valuable customers are or which customer bought the most from you. So what we want to do to be able to figure those things out is we want to use the sort formula. The sort formula is a very simple formula that allows you to say equals, sort, select your array. Once again, your array could be anything. In this case, I'm going to select the entire table. And then you can specify the sort index, which is the column or row. But in this case, you're going by columns. So the column by number on which we want to sort. So in this case, the invoice would be the first column. Column 1, customer name, 2, city, 3, state, 4, country, 5. And the column that we want to sort by is 6, which is the sales value column. Now, for Chris, comma again, I now get the selection of sorting in ascending or descending. I want to do in descending order, so I'll click on that. And I also could have just typed in -1, and now I'm going to get the entire set of data, but it's sorted in descending order. Don't worry too much about the formatting of the value, enough to do the reformat then by just highlighting, and you know that'll still work. So that's all of them, and you know that's how you use the sort formula. But more usefully, I'm going to wrap the sort formula around my filter formula up in here in order to sort these results in a more palatable sequence. And I'm going to do that by simply going to the beginning of my formula, my filter formula, typing in sort, going to the end of the formula, and putting in the column number. Now, in this particular array, we started with customer name, which is column 1. So, you know, city is 2, stage is 3, country is 4, and sales is 5. So I want to sort by column number 5. And again, as we know, I can either double click on the descending, I can put -1 for descending, and now it's going to resort my dynamic array on descending sales for state by the correct sequence. And again, it is dynamic. It is correct if I don't take that, you know, $3,000 invoice that I just added earlier on this tutorial and, you know, change it to say $1,200, it's immediately going to change the sort order. So I've obviously done something very similar with the city sold into, because you notice that they're all sorted alphabetically. So let's unpack that, and we'll do so by getting rid of the sample sort formula that I showed you, and in its place I'm going to show you the basic use of the unique formula. And then again, we'll wrap it in a sort. So let's just say I'm actually now interested in seeing which states we've sold into, not just which cities, but which states. And you know, now select the array. So in this case, I'm gonna say, I'm just gonna grab the states, and I can basically, you know, just simply end the formula right there. And there I now have one entry for every single state. Now, what I did with this one over here, city sold into, is I selected the two columns, city and state. So therefore, if they happen to be, which, and there isn't any data, but if there happen to be, let's say, a Rochester in Utah and a Rochester in New York, then Rochester would have appeared twice, because the unique value would be the combination of both columns. And, you know, this one's already sorted. But again, I can go back to the unique, you know, list of states, and I can wrap that unique in a sort as well. Go ahead and say, let's do it by 1, which is, you know, there's only one column, and we want to see, you know, in ascending order by the default. And now we've sorted these in ascending order. So one thing that you might be wondering about is, you know, what happens if, for example, the records that are being filtered for the sale of the descending sales are, you know, by chance more than a handful of rows, and it's going to spill over into an area where we have other data, like the, you know, city sold into, for example. So, you know, as mentioned earlier, our formula is just in the top left-hand cell of this array, and the rest of it, you know, spills over downwards and across. So if there's anything in any of the cells that want to split into each other, vertically or horizontally, you're going to get an error message. And I'll show you what happens by example. So we'll change this formula to a simple filter that filters the entire table, and we'll filter it by, let's say country equals USA. And there's too many. So let's just do that here. And, in this case, there's too many USA records for it to actually fit into this area. So, what's going to happen is I'm actually just going to get a hashtag and the word spill with an exclamation. So that means this dynamic array formula cannot actually display the results because there's not enough space for it to spill over into. Now, if I delete the offending information, now it'll display. So when you see a spill error, you just need to hit up, you need to free up space in order to allow the dynamic array to show. And again, if I just type something manually into any of the cells that wants to spill into, now I'm gonna get the spill error again. So two final thoughts for this tutorial on dynamic array formulas. And the first thought is that there's many, many other formulae to take advantage of dynamic arrays. Some of them are more recently added, but some of them, you'd be surprised to know, are some of the oldest functions that are available in Excel going back to, 20 years or more, but that are now able to act on a whole array of data rather than only acting on one particular line. The future tutorial in this series will both demonstrate some of the other functions that we're not dealing with here, the newer ones, but also show you how you can use some of the older functions to operate on arrays. So I'll leave you with this final tip from this particular training session, and you may want to reference the results of this dynamic array in another formula somewhere else in your spreadsheet on a different tab, different workbook. And you could do that bearing in mind that the dynamic array exists basically as a dynamic formula just in the top left-hand corner of the range. There's a special way that you have to refer to it. If you simply were in somewhere in a formula to say equals, cell I3, you would simply get the current contents of cell I3. But if you were to reference in any kind of formula the contents of cell I3 but add the pound sign or the hashtag, that tells Excel that as long as it is a dynamic error, you want the entire result set from the dynamic array. And there you see it. So a more practical example of this might be as follows. Let's sort the above array, but in reverse order. So we'll see equal sort, reference the array by taking the top left hand cell and adding the pound sign, and let's sort it based on column 5, which is the value column, but let's sort it in ascending order, which is basically A1, and now we'll get the exact same data, but it's now sorted in reverse order. And again, same thing as before. If we were to change one of the values or one of the items in our original source data, it will update both areas at the same time. So if we were to take Massachusetts, this value east of Chicago, and change that from $1,070 to $6,000, you'll notice that, all of our dynamic arrays updated at the same time. So that's all for this tutorial, but there will be more that expand further on the dynamic array functions and formulas available in Excel. So that's it for our tutorial on dynamic arrays. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more advanced Excel function tutorials coming up.